Hello, everybody. Hello. I just want to say one thing quickly about why I'm here, basically. Firstly, I'm here to support the air ambulance. They saved my life in 2005. Okay? It's a great thing. Like, your being here is actually going to make a difference to somebody's life at some stage. So thank you very much. Okay, and this next track is basically about what happened to me after. We'll wait for the drummer. It needs a little time, yeah, yeah. Okay, then why? What? Okay. I didn't see nothing. Not even my wife or my family suffering. Being told that my chances were more than just slim. 5% would have been a lot more bright than dim. And even if I did show some signs of life within, there was no guarantee that mentally I would have been in charge of my speech or my faculties. Even though communication is one of my biggest attributes, I could have lost it all in a moment of lack of concentration. Forced to face my day of condemnation. Wasn't a typical critical type of patient. Vital organs at some point should have been failing, but I was prevailing and delaying. What even the closest people to me thought was inevitable, and that is and was totally understandable. I don't blame none of you for thinking I was on my way out, because that's just the way the whole scenario was laid out. And if it was you, I probably would have seen the negative too. So this really must just go to show you that you just can't tell. Well, an unconvenient worst place case scenario. Still the lights are out and it's just a total closed. And whatever happens, cling to faith and hope. And if the worst thing happens, use that faith to cope. Because if we haven't got that, truly what have you got? Other than dreams of a lot, we win and then there's money pop. Starvish egotistical needs and whatnot. Amnesia into the eye blue in this little flat and made it easier. I couldn't speak my vocal cords to block one of my trachea. To visit me, men becoming a little weaker. I wasn't that worried because I knew it wasn't forever. That was a fact that I wouldn't be that fat. It's a good job the little strength I did have was in her, because pride and dignity get shut right out the window. Especially when you get somebody you know that comes with a clean exterior, but until it had the straight rules of the naked and fitter. That's just one of the things I was forced to accept. That I'm the fact that the damage done to my lungs would allow me inhale and exhale a little less breath. Almost like inheriting but as a massive jest. I guess health-wise I might be in this footsteps with a bit more of a hop, skip and a limp. Weary of memory and an eagerness to win. Anyway, the second one when they got me posted in, I was more conscious and it was more depressing. And I'm not moaning, I'm just digressing. Analyzing, dissecting and processing the relevance of the story and message I'm pressing into innocent, oblivious minds. It might just be a battle of faith. It's a real hard time. Live today like it could be your last. Leave all the harshness and shit in the past. You could be wrong. All these people that have helped me, because I've been so lucky to be blessed with these two wonderful ladies, by the way, and Matt Hernandez, who's been a massive factor in organising this festival, and he's a real good friend of mine, and you know, it just means everything that he's done this. Thank you, mate. And Frank and Jimmy, please.
Cool. Peace.